我们今天出去查考从第一章十二节到二十一节。
Today, let us continue from verse 12 to 21.
来谈谈我们要如何在真道上坚固。
Let's see how we can be established in the truth.
我们从十二节看到第十五节。
Let us first look at verse 12 to 15.
我们看第十二节这里说，你们虽然晓得这些事，并且在你们已有的真道上坚固，我却要将这些事常常提醒你们。
In verse 12 it says, So I will always remind you of these things, even though you know them and are firmly established in the truth you now have.
那彼得已经在第一章一到十一节把真道教导给信徒。
Now in chapter 1, Peter have hand over the truth to the disciples.
这些真道门徒们信徒们他们已经知道了。
This truth, the believers already have it.
并且已经在这个真道上得坚固了。
And on this truth they stand.
但彼得还是要常常将这些事来提醒他们。
But still, Peter insisted to remind them of these things.
可见已经在真道上坚固的人。
And so we see that even people who already stand on the truth,
仍需要接受虚心，还是要虚心的接受提醒。
We still need to be humble in our hearts to be reminded of the
truth. 否则他们以后可能会慢慢地离开真道。
Otherwise, we will slowly deviate from the truth.
从神宝贵的应许中失落了。
And we would fall from God's precious promises.
我们不要以为我们对真理、对真道非常熟悉。
Let us not think that we are very an expert in the God's truth.
便不需要人常常来提醒我们。
Or that we do not need people to often remind us of the truth.
我们应当记得彼得的提醒。
Let us remember this reminder from Peter.
我们要常存谦卑的心。
Let us have humility in our hearts.
在神的真道上要不停地追求。
On God's word, let us pursue spiritual growth.
也在真道上反省自己。
And also to reflect upon ourselves.
虽然是已经听过很多遍的道了，的真道。
Even though you may think a certain sermon you have listened to it a lot of times before.
但是也要祷告求神给我们有新的领受。
But then you must pray that God will give you new revelations.
让你跟我不是很肤浅的认识真道。
Let us not just scratch the surface of the word of God.
而是很深入的去认识真道。
But to know it in truth and in depth.
常常被真道提醒
to be often reminded of the truth,
我们属灵生命就可以长大成熟
then we have spiritual maturity in our lives.
随时面对困难面对疑惑的时候
and when we meet with difficulties or with doubts,
神的真道能够坚固我们的信心
then there it is, the truth there can establish us.
13到15节
from verse 13 to 15,
彼得就在这段经文当中他以帐篷来代表肉身。
Over here, the Apostle Peter used the term tent to represent our body.
保罗说他要把握机会，趁着还活着的时候。
Peter says that while he is still alive, he will make use of every opportunity.
尽他做仆人的本分。
To fulfill his role as a God's servant.
常常用真道来提醒信徒。
To use the word of truth to remind the believers.
可见我们传福音需要趁机会。
So we see that to share the gospel, we need opportunities.
连要劝勉弟兄姐妹，要造就信徒，也要趁机会。
Likewise, when it comes to encouraging brothers and sisters and edifying them, we require opportunities as well.
这不单是因为主耶稣来的日子已经越来越靠近了。
Not only so because Jesus' coming is near,
也因为我们的肉身的生命是非常有限的。
But also remember that our lives on earth are limited.
当我们还在肉身的日子
While we are still in this flesh,
今生我们一切的侍奉一切的工作
All our service and our work,
我们可以荣耀神的事情都是摆在眼前的。
All the opportunities to glorify God lay before our eyes.
可是当我们有一天离开了这个肉体的生命
But one day when you depart from your body,
一切的机会就没有了。
Then there's no more opportunity at all.
我们虽然在永世中仍然可以侍奉神。
Well, you may say that in eternity we can still serve God.
但是那决定我们将来在荣耀中得奖赏的。
But what determines the rewards you will have in time?
却是我们今世在肉身中的侍奉。
Is what you decide to do today while you are still in this body.
彼得当时他已经年老了。
Peter, at that time when he write this letter, he's aged.
他知道自己很快就要离开这个肉身了。
He knows that he's going to depart from this body soon.
所以他尽量利用这个不多的时间。
So whatever time he has left,
为耶稣的羊群来尽心竭力。
He strive for the Lord's flock.
常常提醒劝勉信徒。
And he often reminded them of the truth.
第十四节，彼得他又提到帐篷。
In verse 14, he mentioned again this term tent.
以色列人从祖宗亚伯拉罕开始。
For the Israelites, beginning from the ancestor Abraham,
都是牧养牛羊的。
They are all shepherds of the flock.
因此，他们常常都住在帐篷中。
So they often lived in tents.
帐篷在圣经中代表寄居的生活。
And in the Bible, a tent represents a nomadic lifestyle.
表示我们活在这个短暂的世界。
It means or symbolizes of our temporal living in this world.
是存着做客旅的态度。
We ought to have a pilgrim's attitude.
却是盼望天上永久的家乡。
Our hope is in heaven above.
彼得预知他自己快要离世。
Peter knew that he is about to depart.
他说是主耶稣基督指示他的。
He said that Jesus Christ made it clear to me.
那彼得可能他记得耶稣从死里复活之后。
Maybe he remembered that after Jesus resurrected,
在海边向他显现时对他所说的话。
Maybe he remembered what Jesus said to him by the beach.
这是记载在约翰福音第21章18到19节。
This is recorded in John chapter 21.
那耶稣当时就对彼得说，
At that time, Jesus said to Peter,
18节说，我实实在在地告诉你，你年少的时候自己束上带子随意往来，但年老的时候你要伸出手来，别人要把你束上带你到不愿意去的地方。19节，耶稣说这话是指着彼得要怎么样使荣耀神，说了这话就对他说，你跟从我吧。
So verse 18 and 19 goes like this, I tell you the truth,When you were younger, you dressed yourself and went where you wanted. But when you are old, you will stretch out your hands, and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go. Verse 19, Jesus said this to indicate the kind of death by which Peter would glorify God. Then he said to him, follow me.
那根据教会的传说，
According to traditions passed down in church,
彼得后来是为主耶稣道钉十字架死的。
Later on, Peter died. He was crucified upside down on a cross.
但是彼得对于自己将面临死亡，他却毫无惧怕。
But facing death in the face, Peter showed no signs of fear.
彼得看似不过是脱离肉身暂时的帐篷。
For he saw that death is but a channel or a means to depart from his body.
灵魂却进入那永久的家乡。
And his soul is going to a better place.
这正是基督徒对死应该有的态度。
And this is the attitude towards death that all of us Christians ought to have.
死对我们来说并不是永远的死。
This death to us Christians is not the eternal death.
乃是脱下这个肉身的帐篷。
It's merely a means of departing from this fleshly body.
我们里头的灵魂要搬去一个更美的地方。
And the soul within ourselves will go to a better place in heaven.
进到与永生神同住的天家。
To be with God in His presence.
所以我们应当趁着未离开这个肉身帐篷之前，
So while you are still in this body of yours,
我们好好地利用我们今生的机会，
Let us use all the opportunities that God has given us.
我们殷勤侍奉神，
Let us serve God diligently.
我们努力传福音，
Let us share the gospel.
我们不停止聚会，
Let us not stop gathering.
第十五节彼得说，当他离开之后，
In verse 15, Peter said that after he departed,
他要信徒纪念他过去常常提醒的真道。
He wants the believers to always remember what he has said.
彼得已经尽量利用他还在肉身的时候，常常勉励信徒。
While Peter is still in his body, his fleshly body, he often reminded the believers.
虽然他自己知道时日不多了。
Although he knows that his time is short.
他仍然要留下真道。
He still wants to leave inheritance of truth,
可以不停地来帮助各时代的信徒，
to help the generations of believers to come.
我们就发现到很多父母他们省吃俭用。
We find some of us are parents, we are thrifty.
他们离开后留下一大堆钱给他们的儿女。
And they leave an inheritance of wealth for their children.
但是很少父母把圣经的教导留给儿女。
But few are the parents who leave a Bible's teachings as an inheritance for their children.
儿女会把母亲、父亲留下的钱都花光了。
This inheritance of wealth could be depleted by their children.
但是如果父母常常提醒儿女圣经的教导，
But if the parents were to often remind their children of Bible's teachings,
这个真道啊，儿女们一辈子也用不完。
This is something that will never be depleted.
有一个很穷的父亲，
There was once a very poor father.
他在树林砍柴的时候，
He was axing some trees in the forest.
就捡到一个陶瓷的水瓶，
He found a ceramic pitcher.
他便顺手的就摘了一朵花，就放在水瓶上。
He conveniently plucked a stalk of flower and put it into the jar.
就摘了一朵花插在水瓶里面。
Just a stalk of flower in the jar.
第二天，水瓶居然长满了花。
And to his astonishment, the next day, in the jar is full of flowers.
所以父亲就试试看，把一粒米就放在水瓶里。
So he did another experiment. He put a grain of rice into the jar.
隔天，那个水瓶居然满了那个米。
The same thing happened the next day. The jug is full of rice.
所以父亲啊，就尝试一下把10块钱放进水瓶里面。
And so the father tried to put $10 notes into the pitcher.
真的，隔天那个水瓶里面全部都是10块钱的钞票。
And just as he expected, next day the jug is full of $10 notes.
从那个时候开始
，From that time on,
这个家庭就过着富裕的生活。
That family lived an affluent life.
父亲就渐渐老了。
As time goes by, the father become older.
有一天
，One day,
父亲带两个儿子来到山顶。
The father brought his two sons to a mountain top by the cliff.
下面是一片大海。
Below the cliff is the ocean.
父亲突然把那个水瓶丢入大海。
Suddenly, the father threw the pitcher into the sea.
两个儿子哇，就觉得非常惊讶。
The two sons were astonished.
父亲就对儿子说。
And the father said to the both of them,
等我死后。
After I die,
难道你们会谨慎地使用这个水瓶吗？
Will you really use this jug wisely?
将这个水瓶丢掉。
Now that I throw this jug away,
是不想你们增加罪孽啊。
It's so that you will not increase your sins against one another.
的确，祖传的财富
，Indeed, the inheritance that God leaves behind
很容易成为儿女的辖制和诱惑
，can become a very easy restriction to the children.
所以，身为父母，应当常常用真道来提醒儿女。
So as parents, we often need to use the Bible's teachings to remind our children.
有了真道提醒的儿女。
And these children who are blessed with this inheritance,
才懂得遵照圣经的教导。
They will know how to obey the Bible's teachings,
谨慎地使用他们的财富。
And to be careful how to use the limited wealth.
这才是父母留给儿女最好的产业。
This is the best inheritance that parents can leave for their children.
第二方面，从16节到18节。
The second aspect I'd like to talk about, verse 16 to 18.
圣经这里说，我们从前将我们主耶稣基督的大能和他降临的事告诉你们，并不是随从乖巧捏造的虚言，乃是亲眼见过他的威严，见过他的威荣。他从父神得尊贵荣耀的时候，从极大的荣光之中有声音出来向他说，这是我的爱子，我所喜悦的。我们同他在圣山的时候亲自听见这声音从天上出来。
The second section 16-18 says,We did not follow cleverly invented stories when we told you about the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we were eyewitnesses of His majesty. For He received honor and glory from God the Father when the voice came to Him from the majestic glory, saying, This is My Son, whom I love, with Him I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice that came from heaven when we were with Him on the sacred mountain.
那彼得在这几段的经文当中
Now Peter, in this few verses,
提到他亲眼看见耶稣在山上变相。
He talks about how he saw Jesus transfigured on the mountain.
这是三本福音书都有记载的。
And this transfiguration is recorded in the first three gospel books.
那当时耶稣带着彼得、雅各跟约翰上山。
At that time, Jesus brought Peter, James, and John up the mountain.
耶稣在山上改变形象的时候。
And when Jesus transfigured,
有摩西和以利亚在荣光中显现与耶稣谈话。
Moses and Elijah appeared in glory and talked with Jesus.
他们就讲到耶稣的受死跟复活的事。
They talked to Jesus about the events of his death and resurrection.
也讲到耶稣降临的事。
They also talked about his coming again.
并且耶稣在山上改变形象所显的荣光。
The glory with which Jesus had when he transfigured.
就是耶稣降临的时候那个荣耀的影子。
It's a representation of a shadow of the glory that Jesus will come with again.
所以彼得在此书说他在山上看见耶稣变相的经历。
So over here, Peter narrated about his experience when he saw Jesus transfigured on the mountain.
证明他所讲耶稣第二次降临的事情。
To show that when he talks about Jesus' second coming,
并不是捏造的谎言。
It is not a fabricated lie.
乃是亲自从耶稣的荣光中所领受的启示。
But it is a revelation that he himself received when he witnessed the transfiguration.
彼得他提这件事情。
Peter talked about this thing.
是因为当时有信徒怀疑耶稣的降临。
It's because at that time there are some believers who doubted Jesus' second coming.
因为有假师傅有异端，随自己的意识来讲解圣经。
There were false teachers and heresies who interpreted the Bible or scripture according to their own interpretation.
所以他们传错误的道理。
So these false teachers, they spread a wrong teaching.
就引诱信徒。
And it enticed some believers.
以致信徒对耶稣再来的真理真道呢产生的怀疑。
That some to the result that some of the believers actually doubted Jesus coming again.
所以神要借着彼得在山上听见的和看见的。
So over here, God uses what Peter has experienced on the mountain.
使他后来在传讲耶稣再来的应许时。
That when Peter preached about Jesus' second coming,
就更有权威而且准确无误。
He'd be more convicted of the truth and he'd be more accurate about it.
可以驳倒那些错误教导真道的人。
To be able to refute all those who preach falsehood.
却能够坚固信徒的信心。
And to establish the believers in the faith.
我们今天如果常常读圣经，常常听真道。
If today we often study the word of God and to listen to the word of God.
我们就不容易被错误的教导所迷惑。
Then we will not be so easily be confused with all kinds of teachings.
我们认识纯正的真道。
If we were to understand the pure teaching of the word,
能够帮助我们有信心等候主耶稣再来。
It will help us to have confidence to wait for God.
耶稣在2000年前第一次降临。
2000 years ago, in his first coming,
他是卑微的、软弱的和贫穷的。
Jesus appeared to be weak and poor.
但他来是要做世人的救主。
But he came to be the savior of the world.
但是当主耶稣第二次再来的时候，
But the second time that when he come again,
他是有大能力、荣耀和威严的。
He shall come with power, glory, and majesty.
他的再来是要来审判天下的。
And this time he come to judge the world.
所以我们必须忠心地侍奉神。
So we must be faithful in our service.
我们要警醒等候耶稣再来。
Let us be watchful as we wait for his coming.
到那个时候，
When that time comes,
我们的灵魂就搬到天上永远的家居住。
Our souls would migrate to our eternal abode.
我们在天家的生活就从那个时候就开始了。
And the life that we live in heaven above will start then.
因此基督徒不是在等死。
Therefore, as Christians, we are not just waiting to die.
我们乃是等候主耶稣再来。
But we are waiting for Jesus coming again.
就连死的信徒在乐园里面。
And even those of us Christians who have already died, who are in paradise now.
也是在仰望等候主耶稣的再来。
Are also waiting for his coming.
然后就可以和主耶稣一同在天家永远相聚。
Then we can be with him forever.
第十七节说，
In verse 17 it says,
他从父神得尊贵荣耀的时候，从极大荣光之中有声音出来说，他是我的爱子，我所喜悦的。
For he received honor and glory from God the Father when the voice came to him from the majestic glory saying, This is my son whom I love, with him I am well pleased.
彼得形容耶稣在山上改变形象时，
Peter narrated about how Jesus transfigured on the mountain.
有神的声音出来。
He talked about how a voice came out.
证明耶稣是神所喜悦的爱子。
Proving that Jesus is the one beloved son of God.
彼得担心这些信徒们受假师傅和异端的迷惑。
Peter worries or is concerned that these believers will be confused by the false teachers' teachings.
怀疑耶稣的神性而信心动摇。
That they would doubt Jesus' divinity and be wavered in their faith.
所以彼得除了证明耶稣再来的真实之外，
So besides proving the truth about Jesus coming again,
也证明神亲自说耶稣是他的爱子。
He also proved that Jesus is the only one beloved son of God.
使信徒不再怀疑耶稣的再来。
So that the believers would not doubt Jesus coming.
耶稣是神的儿子。
Jesus is the Son of God.
这个真理是永远都不会改变的。
This is a never-changing truth.
我们要如何来分辨异端呢？
How are we to distinguish heresies?
其实很容易的。
Actually, it's quite easy.
凡是不认耶稣是神的儿子的，就是异端。
All doctrines which says that or deny that Jesus is the Son of God is a heresy.
所以你就会发现，
And so you will discover,
所有的异端都是否认耶稣是神的儿子的。
All cults out there, they deny that Jesus is the Son of God.
所以我们如果跟某一些人在跟一个基督徒在谈天的时候，
So when we talk with a fellow Christian,
或者如果你在路上有人来跟你传福音，
Or if by your way there's someone come up to you to talk about the gospel,
那你只要问对方一个问题，
You only have to ask them one question.
你所信的你认耶稣是神的儿子吗？
According to what you believe, do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God?
有一些人答不出来。
Or some people, to your surprise, you'll find that they cannot give you an answer.
他们就是可能是异端了，邪教了。
And then you know that they are from some cults.
彼得在十八节就称耶稣改变的山，在山上改变那座山为圣山。
In verse 18, Peter mentioned the mountain as a sacred mountain.
有解经家认为那一座山就是黑门山。
There are some Bible scholars who think that this mountain is actually Mount Hermon.
并非黑门山有什么特别。
Well, it's not that Mount Hermon has anything special about it.
乃是因为耶稣曾在这个地方改变形象。
But rather because Jesus once transfigured on this mountain.
显出耶稣他是圣的。
Showing that Jesus is the Holy Anointed One.
圣经常常将神显现过的地方称为圣。
The Bible often describes the places where God has appeared before as holy.
例如摩西在何烈山见到异象的时候，
For example, when Moses saw the vision of burning bush on Mount Horeb,
神就对他说，
God talked to him,
你所站的地方是圣的。
The place or the ground on which you stand is holy.
约书亚他看见异象的时候，
The same with Joshua when he saw the vision,
也同样听到上帝对他说，
He heardGod said to him,
你所站的是圣地。
The ground on which you stand is holy.
所以不在乎那个地方。
So it matters not about the place or the characteristics of the place.
乃在乎神在那个地方显现。
But it matters only that God was there.
基督徒我们是生活在一个污浊的世界里。
For us Christians, we live in a very filthy world.
但是我们常常住在主耶稣里面。
But we are to live in Jesus. But if we were to live in Jesus,
我们心灵中常常有耶稣同在。
And in our hearts, we often have Jesus with us.
所以我们无论在世界哪一个角落，
Then no matter where you go in the corner of this world,
也因为有神同在而成为圣的。
Because God is with you, you will be set apart and holy.
所以你不会因为住在牧师的隔壁，你就看起来比较属灵。
Now don't think that you are more spiritual just because you have a neighbor of a pastor.
你也不会因为你住在礼拜堂旁边，你就觉得比较圣洁。
And do not think that you are more holy because you live beside the church.
都不是因为地方的问题。
It's not about the place.
乃是因为有神在那个地方。
But it's because God is there.
有一个基督徒他真的相信。
Now there was one Christian who believed.
每次祷告的时候，当他面向圣地耶路撒冷。
Every time he prays, he needs to align his feet towards Jerusalem.
他的祷告就必蒙神的垂听。
Only then will his prayer be heard by God.
所以有一次啊，他跟他的朋友一起坐下来祷告。
So this is one occasion when he and his friend sat down to pray.
所以他的朋友一坐下来。
When his friend sat down,
刚好一双脚就指向那个圣地耶路撒冷。
Just nice, his feet were pointed towards the Jerusalem.
所以那个基督徒就非常生气。
But this strange guy got very angry.
他说你好大胆啊。
He said, what audacity.
你居然敢把你这双臭脚指向圣地。
You're pointing your pair of filthy feet towards Jerusalem.
难道你不怕亵渎上帝吗？
Are you not afraid of blaspheming against God?
所以朋友就对他说了。
So the friend said to him,
那么请你告诉我。
Then advise me then.
我的脚要放在哪里？放在什么地方才不会指着神呢？
How shall I place my feet such that I will never point it towards God?
我们误会了。
We have misunderstood.
我们以为神只在圣地耶路撒冷。
We think that God only dwells in Jerusalem.
那是我们限制了神的能力。
That is us limiting God's power.
不论脚放在哪里，都会指向圣洁的神的。
We know that anywhere we point our feet, it will be always pointed toward God.
因为神是无所不在的神。
Because there is nowhere that God is not there.
我们只要心中有神。
If only we have God in our hearts.
我们就是圣的。
Then we are holy.
所以圣经称基督徒为圣徒。
So in the Bible, it describes Christians as holy.
我们都是分别为圣出来的。
All of us are set apart, consecrated.
所以不论我们住在什么地方，
No matter where you may take your residence,
或者我们去到哪里，
Or no matter where you may go,
圣洁的神常与我们同在。
The Holy God is with us.
我们就有圣洁的言语和行为。
Then we will have holy speech and actions.
能够荣耀我们圣洁的神。
And we can glorify God.
第三方面，
The third section I talk about,
19到21节,
from verse 19 to 21.
彼得这里说，我们并有先知更确的预言，如同灯照在暗处。你们在这预言上留意，只等到天发亮，晨星在你们心里出现的时候，才是好的。20节，第一要紧的，该知道经上所有的预言，没有谁私意解说的。21节，因为预言从来没有出于人意的，乃是人被圣灵感动说出神的话来。
So verse 19 to 21 says, And we have the word of the prophets made more certain, and you will do well to pay attention to it, as to a light shining in a dark place, until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. Above all, you must understand that no prophecy of scripture came about by the prophet's own interpretation. And verse 21, For prophecy never had its origin in the will of man, but men spoke from God as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit.
那彼得讲完自己跟耶稣在山上的经历之后，
After Peter finished narrating about his own experience,
他接下来就特别强调旧约先知的预言。
He carried on to emphasize on the word of the prophets.
是比他自己的经历更加的确定可靠。
Which is more sure and certain than his own experience.
彼得要使徒们，要信徒们重视圣经的话过于人的经历。
Peter wants the believers to emphasize to believe the word of God, the prophets more than their own experience.
如果单单凭个人的经历胜过神的话，
If one should just base his belief on what he experienced over the word of God,
就会有很多的人因为自己没有看见还有听见的经历，
Then many people, because they do not see certain things or do not hear certain things,
结果他就对神的信心就动摇了。
It will cast doubts upon the word of God.
神给每一个人的经历都不同，
The experience that God gave is different for each of us.
但是一切的经历都要符合圣经的教导。
But all these experiences, as edifying as they are, must be aligned with the word of God.
凡是离开圣经真道的经历都是错误的。
You can be sure that all experiences that is not aligned with the scripture or the Bible is erroneous.
都不值得我们谈论，也不值得我们去效法的。
It is not worth our emulation, nor even for our discussion.
那些假先知、假师父、传异端的人，
those who preach false teachings and heresies.
他们教导不诚实跟造假的经历。
They teach the believers about dishonest and fabricated lies.
结果与那些真正从神得到启示的就发生混乱了。
And so there was a clash between these two groups of people, between the false teachers and those who truly received revelation from God.
就是那些信徒们不知道要听从谁的。
To the result that some of the believers do not know who to believe in.
所以如果没有回到这本有权威的圣经，
If you do not go back to this authoritative word of God,
人的经历如果高过神的话，
If we prize man's experience as above the word of God,
就会使我们离开神就越来越远。
It will cause us to deviate further and further from God's truth.
我们最后只听人的话，不再听神的话了。
In the end, we find ourselves more appetizing towards hearing what man says and not what God says.
彼得看见教会有这个危机。
Peter saw this crisis in the church at that time.
所以他要信徒回到圣经先知的预言里面。
So he wanted the believers to go back to the word of the prophets.
使我们以正确的态度来等候耶稣再来。
So with the right attitude, we can wait for Jesus' second coming.
耶稣再来的预言好像一盏明灯。
The prophecies about Jesus in the Bible is like a light shining.
照在这个罪恶与黑暗的世界。
Shining into an evil and dark world.
照明我们回家的路与盼望。
It also shines upon the path by which we take to heaven.
也许我们这些基督徒，我们在生活当中有见证。
Maybe it also help us to have a good testimony in our lives.
好像灯照在黑暗的地方。
Just like light shining into a dark place.
使许多迷失在世界里的人看见主耶稣的光。
If it so shines, many people who are lost in this world can see the light of Jesus.
也跟从我们来救耶稣的光。
And will follow with us to follow the light of Jesus.
第十九节，彼得讲到晨星。
Verse 19, Peter talks about this term called morning star.
那晨星呢，是天亮之前一颗特别明亮的星。
Now this morning star is a star that shines very brightly just before dawn breaks.
是天快亮的预告和确据。
It is like something like a symbol that shows that dawn is coming.
圣经的预言也好像晨星。
And the prophecies in Scripture is like this morning star.
启示我们耶稣快要再来的预言和确据。
It is a confirmation of a symbol that tells us that Jesus is coming.
因此我们现在虽然面对苦难，
Even though now we face sufferings,
但比起将来耶稣再来时我们所得的荣耀，
But if we were to compare these sufferings to the glory with which Jesus will come again,
今生的困难疾病就算不得什么了。
Then it will count as negligible.
我们今生所盼望的，
All that we hope for in our life,
是能回到天家享受那永远的安息。
Is that we may enter into the rest in the heavenly abode.
有一首诗歌，
There is a song.
也是在形容主耶稣他是一颗明亮的晨星。
It talks about how Jesus is like this morning star.
歌名叫主如明亮晨星。
The title is like The Lord is like this morning star.
你们听过这首歌吗？
Have you heard about this song?
唱过这首诗歌吗？
Have you sung it?
我们就一起来跟着荧幕一起来唱。
Let's try to sing according to the lyrics on the screen.
只有两节，副歌比较高，我们注意一点哦。当我在黑暗痛苦绝望中，有一束光明照在我心，它是那成为奇妙的救主，舍弃天上荣华为我降生，他又为我被钉在十字架，情愿受苦洗净我的罪，我要唱奇妙主哈利路亚，从今后永不会
在绝望。他仍赐善良的爱，令我从阔旷风去浪。主如一颗明亮的晨星，带给我无限的希望。
第二节，
救主耶稣基督被接升天，他去愿为我预备地方，就必再来接我到他父家，永远与主同在到千万年。好，那时再没有痛苦悲伤，只有甜美快乐的笑容，从尘土同聚在明亮深沉，满心歌颂赞美主大恩。
副歌，
他仁慈善良的爱，令我从阔旷风去浪。主如一颗明亮的晨星，带给我无限的希望。
副歌重复，
他仁慈善良的爱，令我从阔旷风去浪。主如一颗明亮的晨星，带给我无限的希望。
是的，耶稣他是一颗明亮的晨星。
Indeed, Jesus is like a morning star.
他带给我们将来回天家的盼望。
It brings us great hope, to go to our heavenly abode.
接下来第二十节。
Carrying on, verse 20.
当时有人就按着自己的意思来解说圣经的预言。
At that time, there were people who interpreted the Bible according to their own interpretations.
所以彼得就要信徒注意了。
So Peter wants the believers to take note of this.
他特别强调说，第一要紧的。
He mentioned the word above all.
就是不可以随自己的意思来解说预言。
Telling them not to interpret the Bible or the Scripture according to their own interpretations.
有许多异端就是在预言上发生的错误。
There are many heresies or cults that began because of a wrong interpretation about prophecies in the scripture.
预言既然是预先说明我们未知和未发生的事，
since prophecies are of the nature that talks about things to come,
无法在事实上来得到一个对证，
it cannot be verified in the present truth.
所以这样呢，在当时的那些假师傅跟假异端，
therefore for all the false teachers or cult founders,
他们很容易就凭自己的意思来推测，以来解说。
It's very easy or convenient for them to interpret the scripture according to their own interpretations.
结果出现很多的错误。
As a result, there were many wrong teachings.
使信徒被误导也被诱惑了。
Many believers they are confused or stumbled by this.
在旧约神忠心的仆人先知耶利米。
In the Old Testament, the faithful prophet Jeremiah.
他非常痛恨敌人巴比伦。
He hated the enemies, the Babylonians.
但是当神要他去劝西底家王投降巴比伦的时候，
But when God commanded him, to advise Zedekiah, King Zedekiah to surrender,
他还是要照神的意思讲。
He must preach according to God's word.
虽然他不喜欢，不过他也没有照自己的意思乱讲。
Although Jeremiah may not like it,He must not preach according to his own will.
我们今天查考圣经也是如此。
Likewise, the same today when we study the Bible.
不可以把自己的意思加在神的话语上。
We should not add our own meanings to the passage.
我们不可以曲解神的话。
Such a way that it distorts the truth.
我们自己不对，还要人来遵守我们教导错误的一些的真理。
Moreover, to expect people to obey these wrongful teachings.
在一个很寒冷的冬天,
On a cold winter's day,
主人就把小儿子托付给一个仆人。
Master entrusted his young child, a young son, to a servant.
就叫仆人划船，就带小儿子去玩。
The master asked the servant to row the boat out with the child to see sceneries.
就一上了船呢。And
upon going up the boat,
那小儿子，小主人就睡着了。The
young son, a young master, slept.
所以仆人就独自一个人在划船。So
the servant rowed the boat by himself.
大概划了一个小时。But
1 hour passed.
那个仆人全身发热。And
because of all the rowing, the servant's body began to heat up.
他便把自己的外衣就脱下来了。So
feeling warm, he began to take out his jacket.
这个仆人看见小主人在睡觉。He
saw that this young master is sleeping.
这个仆人就说了。And
this servant said to himself,
我都这么热了。Wow,
I'm feeling so hot here.
你也一定很热。You
too must be feeling hot.
我帮你把你的外衣脱掉，就把小主人的外衣给脱了。So
he took out the shirt of the young master.
之后仆人就继续划船。Then
he carried on rowing the boat.
又划了一个小时。
Another hour gone by.
那个仆人浑身冒汗。
The servant is perspiring now.
他说：“哎呀，太热了，太热了。”
He said, "Whoa, this is too hot."
所以他还是认为小主人跟他一样热。
And he thinks that this young master is feeling hot just like him.
就把自己的衣服跟小主人的衣服都脱光光了。
So he stripped himself and the young master.
可怜这个小主人啊，就。 虽然睡着，不过冷得在那边发抖。So
we pity this young master who was sleeping and shivering at the same time.
有一些过度热心的人,
some people who are overzealous,
好像这个仆人,
just like this servant,
也好像很多异端邪教,
and like many cults and heresies out there,
把自己的错误解释预言强加在别人的身上。
They force their wrong teachings upon others.
很多异端都是如此。
Such is the way of many Pharisees.
例如韩国的统一教。
For example, the Unification Church in South Korea.
他说夏娃和引诱他的蛇通奸。
According to their teachings, it says that Eve and the serpent who deceived her are actually in collaboration.
他们就在神面前犯罪了。
And before God, they sinned.
后来夏娃跟亚当就生下罪恶的后代。
And Eve and Adam later on had sinful descendants.
还有中国的东方闪电。
And also in China, the Eastern Lightning,
也称为全能神教会,
which is also known as the Church of the Almighty God.
她的女发起人自认为自己是女基督,
the female founder of this cult self-proclaimed herself to be a female Messiah.
耶和华见证人却否认耶稣是神的儿子,
as for the Jehovah's Witness, they deny that Jesus is the Son of God.
摩门教却说亚当就是神。
And for the Mormons, they think that Adam himself is God.
还有安息日会,
and also the Seventh-day Adventists.
那个自称女先知的米勒夫人,
the founder, which is Mrs. Miller,
她预言耶稣在1844年再来。
She once prophesied that Jesus will come again in 1844.
但是到了时间耶稣并没有来。
But when the time came, Jesus did not come.
她又赶紧改她的说法。
So she quickly amended her prophecy.
但是有耶稣来了,
she said that 但是, Jesus came,
但是不是来到地面上,
but not onto earth,
乃是进入天上的圣所,
but he is in the holy sanctuary above.
这些都是凭自己的意识错误解释预言的人。
All these are people who interpreted the Bible or the scripture according to their own interpretation.
直到今天,
till today,
仍然有一些人认为自己有超然的启示。
There are still people who think that they have supernatural revelations.
知道耶稣在某日再来,
and they claim or prophesy that Jesus will come on this certain day.
结果成为外人攻击基督徒迷信的笑话。
It became a laughing stock for non-believers to criticize Christians.
其实圣经很早就说明了。
Actually, the Bible has made it clear to us.
耶稣的再来是没有人可以预先知道的。
Regarding the day of Jesus' second coming, no one knows.
在马太福音第24章36节,
in the book of Matthew 24:36,
当门徒问耶稣几时再来的时候,
When the disciples asked Jesus when he will come again,
耶稣这样回答,
Jesus replied thus,
我们一起来读,
Let's read together.
但那日子那时辰没有人知道, 连天上的使者也不知道, 子也不知道, 唯独父知道。 所以圣经很清楚告诉我们,
So the Bible tells us clearly,
耶稣再来的事情根本一个人都不会知道的。
Regarding the time of Jesus' coming, no one knows.
因此一切计算耶稣再来的日子,
So all efforts to calculate the day of his coming
都不是出于神的,
is not from God.
肯定是错误不可信的。
And they come from men, they are not to be believed in.
只要我们多读圣经多听到,
If only we were to study the word of God more,
就容易分辨真理与假道。
Then we will be able to distinguish what is heresy and what is the truth.
使我们能够心存信心跟盼望等候耶稣再来。
Then our hearts will be filled with faith and hope while we wait for his coming.
最后第21节, 彼得说,
And the last verse, 21,
因为预言从来没有出于人意的乃是人被圣灵感动说出神的话来。
Peter said, For prophecy never had its origin in the will of man, but men spoke from God as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit.
旧约先知的预言,
In the Old Testament, the prophecies made by the prophets
是启示未来的事情,
talks about things that are to come.
直到新旧约圣经完成之后,
Until the completion of the Old and New Testament,
全部圣经的启示,
All the Bible's revelations
也都不是出于人意的,
is not from the will of men,
乃是被圣灵感动,
but they came out because they were carried along by the Holy Spirit.
然后说出神的话来,
so men carried along by the Holy Spirit, they spoke the word of God.
这就是圣经神话语的权威。
This is the basis of authority for the Bible.
圣经是神的话,
the Bible is God's word,
是真理,
it is the truth.
我们唯有勤读圣经,
only by diligently studying
我们常听真道,
it, When you often listen to the word of God in the pulpit,
我们就能够在真道上坚固了。
Then can we be established in the truth?
不论异端邪说,
whether it's cults or heresies,
不论疾病困难,
whether in suffering or affliction,
都无法摇动我们对神话语的信靠。
It cannot waver the faith that we have for the word of God.
有一只狗,
there was a dog.
每一次看到小动物,
every time you see small animals,
他都要追到而且把小动物给咬死。
This dog will always want to chase it and bite it to death.
有一次狗就看见一只兔子,
So on one occasion, the dog saw a rabbit.
他就马上追了上去,
and he chased after it.
兔子拼老命地逃,
The rabbit ran for its life.
终于逃过狗的魔爪了。
And finally, it escaped the evil claws of the dog.
这只狗就给别的狗笑它。
But on the other hand, this dog was laughed at by the other dogs.
你说，哎呀，你无能啊，一只兔子你也抓不到。
The other dog say that this dog, you are incompetent. You can't even chase a rabbit.
可是呢，这只狗却为自己辩护说。
But the dog defended itself, saying,
你们不要忘记哦。
Now do not forget.
我追兔子是为了好玩。
I chase the rabbit for fun.
兔子呢？
But as for the rabbit,
它是为了生存而拼老命在逃啊。
It ran for its own life.
兔子拼老命在跑啊。
The rabbit ran for its life.
那的确,
Indeed,
我们为了生存,
for survival,
我们什么事情都会拼命地跑。
We can do anything.
我们也什么事都拼命地去做。
We can do anything.
可是为了圣经的真道,
But for the truth that is set forth in the Bible,
我们会拼命地去持守吗?
That we lay down our lives holding fast to it.
但愿我们都能够依靠神。
So we pray that and hope that all of us may rely on God,
不依靠自己的意识,
and not on our own wills.
用智慧与力量来持守圣经真道。
With wisdom and strength, let us hold fast to the word of God.
也让真道能够坚固我们的心。
Let the word of God stir up our hearts.
使我们有信心跟盼望等候耶稣再来。
That we can have faith and hope waiting for his coming.
我们一起同心祷告。
Let us pray with one heart.